Sigmund Freud, the founder of psychoanalysis, developed a new way of looking at human nature, which has had massive consequences for a wide variety of fields, including psychology, anthropology, semiotics, even artistic creativity and appreciation. Although a highly original thinker, Freud was also deeply influenced by a number of people and events, which overlapped and interconnected with each other to shape the development of his theories. Some of the most important figures in his life were Joseph Breuer, Jean-Martin Charcot, Wilhelm Fliess, Carl Jung, and more. During the winter of 1885 to 1886, Freud spent 4 months at the Salpêtrière Hospital in Charcot's neurology service. His teachings deeply impressed Freud and shifted his interest from general neurology to the study of hysteria and other psychological issues. Freud looked up to Charcot and took on some of his other traits, even collecting small antiques and paintings. One particularly important piece hung in Freud's exam room, where every patient could see it. A lithograph of Une leçon clinique à la Salpêtrière, which depicted Charcot giving a lesson on hysteria. Freud even named his first child after him. Breuer was responsible for introducing Freud to the case of Anna O, and collaborated with him on studies on hysteria. This fascinated him and led to the emergence of psychoanalysis. The mentor-collaborator type relationship Freud maintained with Breuer was archetypal, and was repeated in a similar pattern with Fliess as well as Carl Jung. But Freud and Fliess were a different type of friendship, possibly even a one-sided love story. It all began when Breuer recommended Fliess to take a course in neurology by Freud, and from the moment they met, the connection was instant. As soon as Fliess returned home, their correspondence and letters began. For 17 years, they wrote back and forth, sharing secrets, new findings, and exploring the fields of science and medicine together. Freud's accomplishments during this time were staggering. He began self-analysis, worked on his dream book, and embarked on the exploration of childhood and sexuality. Fliess was quite a character himself. He is most known for three basic theories: the idea that all animal life, including humans, is bisexual, the idea that the nose and sexual function are inextricable, and finally, the concept of innate periodicity. The last idea flowered into what he called biorhythms and included the concept that men also have menstrual cycles. During their friendship, the two men were big influences on each other in ways other than academic. Fliess seemed to have been a major source of Freud's continuous cocaine use, prescribing and recommending it to him on endless occasion, something Freud took on as a habit for his patients as well. Fliess helped Freud come to many ideas, including infantile sexuality, the role of bisexuality in sex and homosexuality, as well as the concept of critical phases in human development. In 1904, their friendship disintegrated due to Fliess's belief that Freud was giving his cycle and biorhythm findings to plagiarists and stealing his idea to use for his own book. This resulted in Freud destroying all the letters Fliess has sent him over the years, possibly out of heartbreak. Freud's innovative treatment of human behavior, analysis of dreams, and his placed importance on our childhood have proven to be extraordinarily fruitful and were some of the most influential academic concepts of the 20th century.